Hello everyone and welcome! As you can tell, I'm right back at my work on my barbecue, and this time, I'm gonna get straight into it. But first, apparently, if you see it at the beginning of the video, you might actually get some, you know, subs and likes. So, please, subscribe, like, share with your friends. Alright, back to work. What am I doing? I'm picking up the mold and seeing how everything came out. Yeah, apparently I had a bit of a drainage and some of the bricks I used just to hold down the mold, hold up the mold, are kind of stuck now. When in doubt, use a crowbar. Let's have a look at it. Please. Okay, as you can see, here I had a bit of a spillage. You can clearly see where the silicone did not help, did not keep it. Right here. This caused it all the way to fall. And these things happen. It's to be expected. At least the front looks absolutely amazing. I'm gonna grab my flex, my angle grinder. I'm gonna clean everything up just a little bit to make sure that everything is fine. Or my file, do it manually. And it's smooth as hell. All right, let's test out the barbecue. See how it's gonna go. Oh yeah, check that out. Sweet. I can even do it the other way around if I need it close for now. This is a temporary solution. This is just enough for this barbecue. Even do, in theory, I could just place it like that, but then it's too big. Like that. I would need a smaller one. That's fine. I'm just going to put it like this for now. And yeah, look at that.
This is just temporary solution. I'm going to add a custom order one that's going to be just the right size to fit in the corner and have everything be smooth. And yeah, look at it. It's just flat. It doesn't bend. It doesn't wobble. It doesn't go into one corner. Yeah, it is a bit flexible because it's only in two points in the back. But yeah, good, great, awesome. I'm gonna leave you right here for a second while I go grab the other one that I bought. Which is the stovetop. I don't know if you can see me mounting this, but it's quite heavy, so I can't hold it. And it's too big. It's too damn big. I was not expecting that. I will actually need to cut it. I will definitely need to cut it, or to cut off its legs, which is most likely what I will definitely do, because it's right on the edge right here. It has these feet. In theory, these should go like in cement or something like that, but since it's just going to be like these feet, I don't know if you saw it. I'm really bad at filming today, I don't know why. So there's that. And apparently I have a bee in my barbecue. She's going to go all the way up. She went away. All right. Lovely little thing on my boat. Like right here. God, I suck at filming today. All right, cool. So what I'm gonna do, not now, but in future, I'm gonna cut off these corners right here so that it stays flush, and it's done. Look at it. Look how beautiful it is. Oh yeah. Making a fire, making a... Look at that. Look at that. Absolutely awesome. Cool, cool, cool. I'm gonna need barbecue tools. I can't believe I went to the store, bought a few stuff, and didn't think to get barbecue tools. What? Are you kidding me? Usually, this would not have passed inspection for me. Alright. Can't believe I didn't check that. Alrighty then. I'll just click that out. Alright, moving on to the next ones. I'll put you back. This is my new countertop. Look at it, the smoothness of it. Look at how beautiful it is. Oh yeah, now I'm talking. Now you're talking. I think I might give it a little bit of a sand once I get my belt sander back, because it's gonna take a while. But yeah, there are a few things over here and there, like over here. It looks really nasty on camera, actually. It looks better in real life. But I'm going to sand this down. It should be good. Look good. There is still the bottom of the sink that needs to be done and poured the same
type of concrete over this, because it definitely needs a new coat. The sides, I will see what I can do about it, but I'm also inclined to just leave them as is. As long as they hold water, I don't really care. So yes, that is the completed barbecue done. Isn't that wonderful? There are a few more things to be done, like wooden doors all around the base to make everything good, and a coat of paint. But yeah, it looks great, doesn't it? I mean, I love it. To the finalization of another project. This is the pump housing that I made last time. It's really, really crooked. You can't really tell while on camera, but it's so actually you can tell. The bricks are really, really crooked, and there's nothing really I can do about it. I got the top part to be level. I think I'm going to leave it, and the top part is not even cemented, and I'm not going to cement it, so I can have access from the top and from the bottom. What I'm going to do now is clean it up, because it's incredibly good. And for that, I'm just going to put you like this, and I'm going to go grab my angle grinder and clean everything up. case you saw me running out of frame and some screams in the recording, that would have been my son who stopped his bike into a car. Don't worry, he's fine. Oh yeah, and the car is fine. Okay, I'm done with the pump. It's not pretty, it's not nice, it's done. But it has a really nice faucet. Okay, I'm gonna get started working on the plumbing for the outhouse. But first, I have to dig a hole, one of the favorite pastimes I do. So, it's right over there. And that's why I'm gonna dig a hole, go down, and come with a drain for the shower, outdoor shower, and that's it. That's the plan for now. Then I'm gonna make the mold again for the concrete foundation slab, and hopefully I'll have time to pour that one today. All right, I'm gonna flip it now so it gets better camera quality. All right, breaking for lunch. Be right back.
All right, back to work.
Why am I cutting this and why did I do what I did? I check and if I just add like the 45 degree angle, which I want for my toilet, it's too low. And I risk it being below the level of the cement. And I don't want to do that. So I want it to be like almost flush with cement or a bit above. It doesn't really matter as long as it's not way above. But this one is too high up. With the 45 degree would be too high. So just adding this about halfway will get it like flush what I want with the 45 going just enough above. So I'm gonna cut about this much. I'm just eyeballing it. And this should be like plenty. The angle grinder, I can use it to cut this, but it's soft material and this is a very good pen saw.
is going to be doing up to the trick. So I'm going to do it fast with this one. Alright, well, let's give you a close-up. So, that's going to be the main entry, the drain for the toilet. And what we have over there is the drain for the shower, which is going to be right outside and going that way. I can actually... Now I realize that this is a little too close to it, but that's okay because I can do it like this. And that way I get, 20 centimeters something, and it's right where it needs to be in the center. Or towards, I'm going to have to angle it that way. We'll see. Anyway, it's good. Now I'm going to have to fill it in, make sure that everything's stable, and then dig a trench. sorry about that. Dig a trench around it so that I can make the mold a little in the ground, and then fill it up with bricks, and in a later day I will actually pour the cement, because I realize I don't have enough cement. I only have 3 sacks of cement, and that is definitely not enough in my experience. 3 sacks of cement barely cover like 1 countertop for that, so I'm gonna need at least 5 to 8 more, just to be sure. I'm probably gonna have at least 10 bags ready to go when I do this, minimum. All right, back to work.
because I moved it quite a lot. Okay, what am I doing? Why did I put it, then I took it off? I want to get a straight angle, a 90 degree angle, but I also want it to be sort of in line with it's fairly in line with the rest of the things that I built on the property, right? I don't want it to be crooked. And I initially started with the back wall, with the back wall, and I realized that if I put a 90 degree versus the one that I laid down, it would be a little crooked versus the rest of the thing. So I started with the front, which will be the door for where everyone enters, and I'm going to make the size and the sides 90 degrees, and then the back, this one back should be like. All right, I'm getting to the end now for the work today. I'm just going to put in these little guys. They're going to be the supports for the pillars going up. But in order for me to put them in, I have to put them exactly at 90 degrees and on position. So I'm going to use some other board just to set them at the right dimension.
There will be other anchors in this month, but those will not go. Those will not be this heavy and, you know, poured into cement board. Cement poured around it, right? I'm just going to drill screws and put in this. Alright, I'm done with this. So I'm gonna gather my tool, and the final step that I'm gonna do, I'm going to lay a few bricks to fill in that space more, to offer resistance to the concrete, and to minimize the amount of concrete that I need. I'm not gonna put bricks everywhere so that it's like a complete floor of bricks. Rather, they're going to be like rows upon rows and crisscross, so that cement will fill in the gaps and I'm going to make it like really watered down cement mostly, so that it pours and it will flow. That's why I dug into the ground and I made the mold go in, and I kept earth around it so that it doesn't spill out anywhere. At least that's the plan. I really, really hope it works. I'm gonna find out. Next. Oh, the weather is good. It's coming.
Since we have a septic tank, that bucket is going to stop rainwater from filling it if it does rain and overfilling up the septic tank with rainwater because it's already done. But yeah, that's going to be our toilet, outdoor toilet, and outdoor shower. I'm gonna go start grabbing bricks. And I guess that's it. I'm gonna pull you up like this, show you what I've done. Okay, so the plumbing is done. Remember, the drain is right under that bucket, which is there just to protect the drain from rain momentarily. These are gonna be laid out just like that. They're gonna stay for a week, maybe one day, depending on how I feel. So yeah, that's one. Is that? I decided to do it like this instead of putting rebarb in between. One, because I have no more rebarb. And this is a
simpler solution, and I don't think it needs that much strength. It should be enough. It's just like a small box on top of it with a slight slope. So I doubt it's going to need that much resistance. I'm pretty sure this is gonna be just fine. Again, I'm not a structural engineer, but it should be fine. The famous last words. All right, that's the word for today, plus what we did on the barbecue and everything. I was planning on pouring the bottom of the sink, but I'm just absolutely too goddamn tired to do that right about now. All right, let's flip.
If you enjoyed the content, oh my god, I look like a shipper. Oh man, I have a weird thing. I know it's hot outside, but any wind stuff does special things to me. Alright, thank you all for checking this video out. I know it's probably gonna be rather long. I don't know, I haven't edited it yet. But if you enjoyed the show, please subscribe, like, share it to the friends. You know, that works. I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye. Weather's getting good.